Welcome to an example on how to factor a trinomial in the form ax squared plus bx plus c by the grouping technique when a is not a common factor among all three terms. So here we're asked to factor 6y squared minus 13y plus 5. To factor a trinomial in this form using the grouping technique, we need to find two integers, which we'll call R and S, whose product is equal to a times c, where a is the coefficient of the degree 2 term, and c is the constant term, and whose sum is equal to b, the coefficient of the degree 1 term. So again, we're looking for two integers, r and s, whose product is equal to a times c, and whose sum is equal to b. Once we find the value of r and s, we'll write the given trinomial in the form ax squared plus rx plus sx plus c, and then factor by grouping. So essentially, we use the values of r and s to rewrite the degree 1 term as a sum or difference. Looking at the given trinomial, notice a is equal to 6, b equals negative 13, and c equals positive 5. So again, we're looking for two integers that have a product of a times c. Well, a times c is 6 times 5, which equals 30, and also have a sum of b, which is negative 13. Notice how, because we're looking for two integers that have a negative sum and a positive product, both integers will need to be negative. Let's begin by listing the pairs of negative integers that have a product of positive 30, which would be negative 1 times negative 30, negative 2 times negative 15, negative 3 times negative 10, and negative 5 times negative 6. Again, we're looking for two integers that have a product of positive 30, but also have a sum of negative 13, which means we're looking for the integers negative 3 and negative 10. Again, because negative 3 times negative 10 equals positive 30, and negative 3 plus negative 10 is equal to negative 13. So let's let r equal negative 3 and s equal negative 10. And now we'll use the value of r and s to rewrite the middle term as a sum or difference. So we'll write the given trinomial as 6y squared, and then we'll write minus 13y as minus 3y minus 10y. And we still have plus 5. And now we factor this using the factor by grouping technique. So now we divide the four terms into two groups, and now we factor out the greatest common factor from the first half and the second half, and we should have a common binomial factor. Factoring 6y squared minus 3y, the greatest common factor is 3y, so we'll factor out 3y again just from the first two terms. We factor out 3y from 6y squared, we're left with 2y. If we factor out 3y from negative 3y, we're left with negative 1, so we have minus 1. And now looking at negative 10y plus 5, notice how the greatest common factor is 5. But if we factor out 5 from negative 10y, we're left with negative 2y. We want to factor a positive 2y, so let's factor out negative 5. So write minus 5, then we have the remaining binomial factor. If we factor out negative 5 from negative 10y, we're left with 2y. If we factor out negative 5 from positive 5, we're left with negative 1, and therefore we have minus 1. So looking at these two products, notice how we have a common binomial factor of 2y minus 1. So we'll factor out 2y minus 1 from these two products. Notice how this would leave us with 3y minus 5, which gives us the second binomial factor. So this is the factored form of the given trinomial. Before we go, though, let's multiply this out to check our work. By now we know we'll have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 2y times 3y is 6y squared. 2y times negative 5 is negative 10y, or minus 10y. Negative 1 times 3y is negative 3y, or minus 3y. And finally, negative 1 times negative 5 is positive 5, so we have plus 5. Combining like terms, notice how we do get 6y squared minus 13y plus 5, which does verify our factored form is correct. I hope you found this helpful.